In this section, we're going to be covering the warp tool. Now, as the name suggests, it allows you to warp objects, whether it's text, whether it's a shape, but they have to be vector. So just so you know, I have made an in-depth tutorial on this, so you can go and check that out, but we're going to be covering the basics here. So let's start off with a basic shape. So I'm going to be applying it to this square here, but before I do that, it's going to be more evident if I have some stripes in there. So I'm just going to turn on snapping so it just gets into the middle there. And I'm going to clip it inside of the square shape. Now they all move around as one. I can turn snapping off now. Okay, so where is this warp tool? Well, if you go over to layers, just underneath, there's a little icon there. This one here, it says warp as you hover over it. Click on that. Once you've clicked on it, you'll see there's a few options here. Mesh, quad, perspective, etc. To begin with, just select quad. Now that I've selected that, you can see in the context toolbar, we have those same options again. If we click up here, we could cycle through them. Leave it on quad for now. We have some snapping options, which I'm going to show you. We have mute mesh, that's coming up as well. And then we have convert to curves right at the end. So you can warp as much as you want here. Make the shape you want, and then if you're really sure you want to keep it, you can convert it to curves, which means it bakes in that style. But just know that if you do apply this warp tool at this point and you don't click convert to curves, it is non-destructive. So if you warp to a shape that you like, but then later on you want to make changes to it or you want to go back to its original shape, you can do that. So let's get started. So now that we're in the warp tool, what can we notice? Well, we have four nodes on the outside, but they're round this time. They're kind of like warp nodes. I can go ahead and click on these and drag it around. And you see, as I've put those stripes in there, it's more evident what's going on. So I can play around with these corners as much as I want. And notice it still says quad. But if I go ahead and, let's say, drag this side out, so I'll click and I'll drag that out like that, and I'll let go, you can see that it's now turned into mesh. The warp mode is now mesh. It's not quad anymore. And basically, you can further customize it now. When I think of mesh, I think of some kind of grid. These nodes here, we only have four of them because we started off with a quad, but they allow us to just click on the sides somewhere. So I'll click there, and you see now I have a path going along, and I can play around with this handle. And we can start creating our own mesh. So I could just add a couple of nodes there or junctions. Let me just play around with this one up here, and I'll hold the handle, and it's just like when we were playing around with the shapes. You get these handles and these nodes, but these are called junctions in the warp tool, and you can see I can pull it out and I could do this, and it kind of happens quite smoothly. I'll do it on this side as well, might be a bit more evident. There we go. So it kind of looks like a flag now, and I can hold this side and pull that out as well. So these are round right now, and if we go up to junction, I've got that one selected. It says it's a smooth node, but I can switch it to a cusp, which is basically like a sharp node. So I'm going to click on that, and you can see it has turned square. And now when I hold this handle and move it, it kind of comes to a sharp edge there. Whereas this one, if I hold it and do this, it's a lot smoother, isn't it? Let me hold the vertical one, actually. There we go. It's a lot smoother, the transition there. So you can play around with the different junctions. Let's look at snapping. So if I just move these two down, be a bit more obvious then. Okay, so we'll go to snapping. The first one is just like snapping with the nodes in the pen tool or the node tool. So the first one says align to nodes of selected curves. If I select that one and I just click on one of these, as I go down, you see it will snap to these different junctions. So if you're a bit particular with your design, you can turn that on. Okay, let me move this one up. What about if I selected two of these? Well, I can just hold and select two of these nodes here. This is the one I will grab. I will click on it and move up. And you can see it snapped to the node on the right. But if I keep moving up, will it snap to that other one that I've grabbed? No, it isn't. So this is where the next option comes in, the snapping option. Snap all selected nodes when dragging. So I'll click on it and just show you. So I'll click and drag that up. Yes, it snapped to the first node. I keep dragging up, and yes, it snapped to the second node. So those are your snapping options. And you see now we have a mesh. There's these lines going left and right, up and down. If I no longer want to see that, I can just click on mute mesh, and I'll kind of see the mesh of the warping that I'm doing, but I can see the original shape behind. Okay, now let me show you how it's non-destructive. So let's say I keep it like this, this strange warp that I've done. So I no longer want that anymore. If we look in the layers panel, we can see that it has created a warp group. And if I click on this arrow here, you can see in there is the original layer that I had. So if I click and drag that out, you can see this is the thing we started with. But if I click and drag it back in, you can see it takes on that shape again. So that's non-destructive. You can always take it out of that warp group and it'll be back to the way it was. Okay, I'm going to click off now. And if I click back on it again, how do I get back into those warp options? Because I'm not seeing them anymore. Well, you simply head to the node tool or you press A on the keyboard. And now you're back in the warp tool mode. So let's convert it to curves. Let's say we're really happy with it. We're not going to go back. Let's go up and just click on convert to curves and see what happens. So I've clicked it and there's this bounding box around it. But if we look in the layers panel, we can see group here. If we just click on that inside, this is the group that we want. So I can drag that out and you see this group here. I don't no longer need that. It's just an empty group. And if we look at this and if I just look what's inside of it in the child layers, I can see all of those stripes are there. They're all nodes and they're all curves. So that would be the destructive way of keeping your item as it is, but you don't need to do that unless you're absolutely sure. Okay, let's move on and try it on some text. So I'm going to delete that and let's move down to this warp text here. So like before, I've got it selected. I'm going to go down to the warp tool, click on it. And this time I'm going to choose one of these other ones. So arc horizontal. So as soon as I've clicked on that, it's given us this arc. And we look up in the options here, we have a value. We can click on that value and drag it in and out like this. So it's a very quick way of adding an arc to some text. Also, I can go to arc vertical and it will show me what it would look like there. And you can just cycle through seeing which one you want. And when you do find the one you want, you can continue to customize it further. So bend horizontal, there it is. You've also got fisheye. These are presets of things that you could actually do yourself, but it just makes life slightly easier, doesn't it? And then we've got twist as well. But for now, let's keep it on arc horizontal and leave it like that. Okay, moving on to the last example. In fact, I'll get rid of that so it just gets out of the way. Okay, so we've got the Welsh flag here in front of us. Basically, just like my first example, we had a square with some stripes clipped inside of it. And this is much the same. I have a shape, a rectangle shape, and the inside there is all of the design. And it's all vector. I can go ahead and apply it to this. So again, we'll go down to warp, click on that. I will start off with quad, because I'm going to make it kind of wave in the wind, I guess. So the first thing I'll do is I can click and drag on these two junctions here and drag it up. And then I will just click and drag this down and I'll click and drag this down as well. And then this handle appears because I've just pulled those sides out and I could just keep playing around with it like this. So starting off with quad was quite a good idea. Obviously now it's turned into mesh again, as you can see, and we can make further amendments to it. So I can add a couple more of these points here. Maybe it's really windy, so this one I want to go up and whip out like that, and I want to drag that out as well. You can get really creative with maybe how it's blowing in the wind. Add a couple more in the center there so it looks super warped. And you can keep adding to this as much as you want. And this is a pretty bad example, actually, of how a flag might wave in the wind. But if you check the full tutorial, you'll see I actually did it quite well. So there it is. There's the basics of the warp tool. Let's move on.